meeting is now being recorded.
Welcome to the Crossroads Food Prescriptions Webinar, Part 1. This webinar is intended for CPAs. It is important to understand that this webinar is being recorded while we are still in the pilot and testing phases of Crossroads. As we go forward, there may be minor tweaks to the application. It is critical when you come to roll out training that you have a basic understanding of how Crossroads works. Therefore, we do suggest the following. View this webinar as often as you need until you feel comfortable with the contents. Play in the sandbox. We will be staggering access to the sandbox based on your rollout dates. Your work director will let you know when you can access the sandbox and how to do so. We will also provide scenarios to guide your practice. As you play in the sandbox, make note of your questions and bring them to rollout training. We will now navigate to Crossroads to take a look at the food prescription functions. These functions are used to create a new food prescription, modify an existing food prescription, set the family issuance date, and the issuance frequency. When you navigate to the prescribed food screen, the system analyzes the information of the participant to determine if there is a current prescription for each category. Each time you visit the prescribed food screen, the system examines the current record and determines whether the current prescription is appropriate based on regulations for each of the 7 basic food packages. Crossroads does provide a default food package determined by WIC category, age, breastfeeding status, multiple fetuses, or multiple breastfeeding status. So as you see on your screen, we have just certified the Gold family. So looking at the left-hand side of the quick links, we'll go to the Issue Benefits and Prescribed Food screen. And as you can see, mom, who is pregnant, is selected in the carousel, in the family carousel. So we'll take a look at this screen before moving on. So starting at the top, we see the food prescription carousel, which contains, by date, all the prescriptions of the selected family member. The food prescription date field is the prescription's effective date. By default, the value of the food prescription date is the date on which the prescription is assigned. The WIC category, as you can see, is pregnant for this participant, but it would be breastfeeding or child for other participants. Breastfeeding status does appear if you have a breastfeeding woman or a postpartum woman. Age category appears for infants and children, and the family issuance day defaults to the day of the prescription. Issuance frequency defaults to the number of months for which a participant is eligible for benefits. In this case, it's 3 months. Looking down on the page, the food prescription items container, we see the category. It's a list of foods that are available to the in this category of participant. The subcategory further defines each food, and the quantity is the amount prescribed to the participant based on the category. The category max quantity is the maximum amount allowable for the participant, and there's also a unit of measure, or UOM. It's the measure for the food. Looking further down on the page, we see the Add Item to Food Prescription Container. Note that these buttons remain grayed out until a new prescription is added. The category is a list of foods that are available in this category of participant. It's a drop-down list. Subcategory further defines each food. There are some differences with the subcategories depending on the category of participant. Quantity is the amount prescribed to the participant. Max, or MedMax, is the maximum amount for the category of participant without medical documentation. And the MedMax is the maximum amount allowable with medical documentation. And once again, we see the unit of measure, or UOM. There are several modifications that can be made to the food prescription. We will start by looking at the food prescription date, the family issuance date, and the issuance frequency. A food prescription can be entered and modified for the current date and future dates. Once created, the date cannot be modified and the food prescription cannot be deleted. The user can view previous food prescriptions using the food prescription carousel. So we're going to click the Create New Food Prescription Add button, which is the green plus sign under Food Prescription Date. The Select New Food Prescription Date pop-up window displays. Select the date for the new food prescription by adding it into the date field or click on the calendar and select the correct date for the prescription to begin. This can include a date in the future. If there is no prescription for the current date, the system defaults to today's date. Only one food prescription is allowed per day for the WIC category and age. You cannot use the date in the past. We will not save this information at this time. We will click Cancel. To modify the food, the family issuance date, we can click on the Edit button, which is the pencil located on the left. The family issuance day defaults to the day of the month the family was initially certified. This date determines the first day of the month, first day to spend, that is issued benefits that may be used for that month. This date may be modified. If it is modified during a period when a family is receiving benefits, it is likely to result in some family members having benefits prorated for the first month the change date is in effect. A new infant added to a family will automatically sync up to the family issuance date. If a new participant is added to a family who has an established family issuance date, the Crossroads system will automatically prorate a food package if a full month issuance is not possible. Crossroads will do all the proration for you. Click on System Defined to change the issuance date to match that of another family member, or click on Custom to enter a new issuance date of the month. The new day is assigned to the family, not individual participants. When you click on System Defined, you will only see other options for issuance date if there is another family member with a different date. For example, if mom's issue date is 5 and the child's issue date is 12, you would only be able to change the mom to 12 or the child to 5. But you would not be able to select any other day using this function. If you needed to change to any day other than 5 or 12, you need to click Custom. So once again, we'll cancel out of this and not save our changes. To modify the issuance frequency, click on the Edit button with a pencil and select a new frequency from the drop-down list box. The issuance frequency determines how many months of benefits a family will receive when benefits are issued. The maximum period is 3 months. Once again, we will not save our changes. We'll click Cancel. Okay, now we will move on to modifying food prescriptions. We're going to select the child icon in the family header. So if we needed to add a new prescription, we would do so by clicking on that green plus sign, but it looks like we don't have to. Okay, so we'll look at the food prescription container and look at the milk for the child. We're going to adjust the quantity by making the milk quantity 5 instead of 4. You see that the system gives you an error message because the quantity, the category max quantity is above 4. so we cannot prescribe more than what is allowed for a child's food package. We will modify the food package by putting the milk back to 4 and changing the legumes to 0. So as you can see, we did not get an error message this time. Crossroads allows you to underissue, but you cannot overissue. One of the most common changes to make to a food package is a milk substitution. In Crossroads, this is referred to as adding an item to the food prescription. We will be looking at adding cheese, tofu, and lactose-reduced milk for women and children. We will be looking at several changes to the food prescription. Okay, so we're going to add an item to the food prescription. So first you need to select an item from the category. So we'll select cheese. And from the subcategory, we'll select cheese in a 16-ounce package. The quantity will be 1. And then we'll click Add Item. Because you added cheese without reducing the milk, you get a validation summary message that shows that milk quantity must be reduced. The milk substitution calculator displays when cheese is added. You will use this to determine how much milk needs to be removed from the prescription. We will adjust the milk quantity on the food prescriptions item container to allow for the substitution of cheese. 1 pound of cheese is equivalent to 0.75 units of milk. The validation summary warns that milk substitution indicates the milk must be reduced by 0.75 gallons. So we will reduce the milk to 3.25 and the error message disappears. At this point, the package can be saved, but we will show some different substitutions, so we will not be saving this food package. Substitutions for milk may be made without medical documentation for certain food packages only. If necessary, as in the case with tofu for a child, you would need to obtain a medical documentation prior to the substitution. So now we will demonstrate a tofu substitution. So if need be, you needed to create a new food prescription by clicking on the Add button, but we won't need to do that. So looking at the Add Item to Food Prescription Container, from the category drop-down box, we will select cheese. The subcategory is tofu in a 14 to 16 ounce package, and we'll enter the quantity of 4. And we'll click Add Item. The attached medical documentation screen displays and indicates that documentation is required for tofu. So we will complete the screen. We'll enter a medical reason. And we will document that we've received a verbal order from the physician. We'll enter the physician's name and the physician's phone number. Notice that those are starred fields that we need to complete. We will now click Save to save the medical prescription. And if you received medical documentation from the participant's provider, you will be able to scan that documentation into Crossroads. Because you added tofu without reducing the milk, you get a validation summary message that shows that milk quantity must be reduced. The milk substitution calculator displays when tofu is added. You will use this to determine how much milk needs to be removed from the prescription. 1 pound of tofu is equivalent to 0.25 units of milk. The validation summary warns that the milk substitution indicates the milk must be reduced by 1 gallon. When reduced to 3, the error message disappears and the package may be saved. Normally, you would save this food prescription, but we will continue on and show you more examples of modifying a food package. In this next example, we will substitute lactose-reduced milk for all the milk. Even though lactose-reduced and lactose-free milks are sold in half-gallon containers, substitutions are made for gallons. So once again, under the Add Item to Food Prescription, under Category, we will select Milk Low-Fat / Fat-Free. The subcategory is lactose-reduced milk / lactose-free milk, and the quantity is 4. And we'll click Add Item. Once again, because you added lactose-reduced milk, without reducing the milk, you get a validation summary message that shows that milk quantity must be reduced. The milk substitution calculator displays when lactose-reduced milk is added. You will use this to determine how much milk needs to be removed from the prescription. 1 gallon of lactose-reduced milk is equivalent to 1 unit of milk. The validation summary warns that the milk substitution indicates the milk must be reduced by 4 gallons. So we reduce the milk to 0, and we'll see the error message disappear. Once again, you would normally save this prescription, but we will not save it. Okay, so we will save this prescription now. Now that you've seen several different examples of modifying a food package, so this completes part 1 of the food prescription webinar. Thank you.